We already know how to subtract two binary numbers directly, but direct binary subtraction becomes complicated as the number size increases. So in this presentation, we are going to learn binary subtraction using 1's complement. If I want to subtract b from a, I will write a minus b. This is direct subtraction. I can also write this as a plus of minus b. So the first thing that we have to do is to find out negative of b, and we can see from step number 1 we have to convert the number to be subtracted. Number to be subtracted is b in this case to its 1's complement form. So we have to find out 1's complement of b, and you already know 1's complement of any number is equal to negative of that number. So 1's complement of b is equal to minus of b. So we have our minus of b, and in step number 2 we have to perform the addition. We have to add minus of b with a. Then we will move to step number 3, and this is step number 3 is the most important step. In this step we have to focus on final carry. If the final carry is equal to 1, we have to add this 1 to the result obtained in step number 2. Let's say when you add a plus minus of b is equal to s, and if the final carry in this sum, if the final carry in this sum is equal to 1, then you have to add 1 to the sum, and whatever you are going to have after this, let's say we have t, then t is your answer. This adding of final carry is known as end around carry. End around carry, and this is very important. We will discuss this after some time. And if the final carry is equal to 0, the result obtained in step number 2 is negative and in the 1's complement form. So if you add a and minus b, and let's say sum is equal to s, and final carry in this case is equal to 0, then this sum is negative and in 1's complement form. So we have to invert it to get the answer. This will be more clear when we solve one example. So let's move to our example number 1, and in this example we have to perform the subtraction in which the first number is 1100. This is in binary, and the second number is 0101. So you can clearly see a is equal to 1100 and b is equal to 0101, and from step number 1 we have to convert the number to be subtracted. The number to be subtracted is 0101 to its 1's complement form. So we will find out 1's complement of b. 1's complement of b is simply 1010. We have to complement each and every bit, and we have to add 1100 and 1010 in step number 2, because 1010 is nothing but minus of b. So we will do this quickly. 1100 plus 1010. 0 plus 0 is 0, 0 plus 1 is 1, 1 plus 0 is 1. 1 plus 1 will give us sum equal to 0 and carry equal to 1. So you can see the final carry is 1, and when final carry is 1, we have to add it back to the result obtained in this step number 2. So we will add 1 here, and we are going to have 0 plus 1 equal to 1 and 1 1 0. So 0 1 1 1 is the answer of example number 1, and you can cross check this. A is 1100. This means it is 12. B is 0101. This means it is 5, and we have to find out 12 minus 5, or we can write 12 plus of minus 5. Minus 5 is equal to 1010. So this is minus of 5 in decimal. 12 is in decimal, 5 is in decimal, and this is 12. 12 plus of minus 5 will give us 7, very simple. But you can see 0110 is not equal to 7. We have to neglect this one because of overflow. When you subtract two 4-bit numbers, result is not going to be 5-bit. This is a 4-bit number. This is also a 4-bit number, and result is 5-bit, which is not possible. So we have to neglect this one, and we are left with 0110. 0110 is what? 6. 0110 is 6. So the answer is not correct because it should be 7. So we have to end around the carry, and we will add this 1, which will give us 0111, and decimal equivalent of 0111 is 7. So the answer is 7, and we have to end around the carry whenever the final carry is equal to 1 in 1's complement. This is the most important point in this presentation. So note it down because it will help you a lot. And there is one disadvantage of 1's complement as compared to the 2's complement, because in 1's complement there is end around carry involved. But in 2's complement there is no need to add the final carry back to the result. We can easily neglect the overflow and we will have our answer. So we will prefer 2's complement over 1's complement when we have to perform the subtraction of two binary numbers. Let's move to example number 2. In example number 2, we have to perform the subtraction 0101 1100. So we have to perform the subtraction, and A is equal to 0101, B is equal to 1100. We have to find out minus of B, so we will take the 1's complement of B. So minus of B is equal to 0011. We complemented all the 4 bits, and now we will perform the addition. 0101, A is 0101, and minus B is 0011. We will perform the addition, and let's see what we have. 1 plus 1 is 0 with carry equal to 1. 1 plus 0 plus 1 is again equal to 0 with carry equal to 1. 1 plus 1 plus 0 is 0 with carry equal to 1, and finally we have 1. So 1000 is the result of this step number 2, and you can clearly see the final carry is equal to 0. The 0 is the final carry, and whenever the final carry is equal to 0 from step number 3, you can see result obtained in step number 2 is negative and in the 1's complement form. So the result obtained here, 1000, is negative. This is negative and 1's complement form. So we have to invert this answer. So we are going to take the 1's complement of this result, and this will give us 0111. 0111 is 7 in decimal, and this shows that 1000 is minus of 7 in decimal because this is negative. And you can cross check this. 0101 is 5. 0011 is minus of 12. And when you add 5 and minus of 12, you are going to have minus of 7. So this is our answer. So these are the two cases that you have to understand in 1's complement subtraction. When carry is equal to 1, you have to add it back to the answer. And when carry is equal to 0, just invert it and you will have your answer. If you have any doubt regarding any part of this presentation, you can ask in the comment section. And regarding this end around carry, you can do a simple calculation that will explain you end around carry more. If I want to subtract 1 from 2, I will write 2 minus 1, or I can write 2 plus of minus 1. 2 is 0010, 1 is 0001, or I can say plus 2 and plus 1. Minus of 1 is equal to 1110. I just complemented all the 4 bits, and now we can perform the addition. I will put 0010 here, and I will put 1110 in place of minus 1. So we will have 0 0 1 0 1 1 1 0. And now we can add this. 0 plus 0 is 0, 1 plus 1 is 0 with carry equal to 1. 1 plus 0 plus 1 is equal to 0 with carry equal to 1. And again we have sum equal to 0 with carry equal to 1. And you can clearly see we performed the subtraction of two 4-bit numbers. This is 4-bit and this is also 4-bit number. But the result is 5-bit. So we have to neglect this 1 and we are left with 0, 0, 0, 0, which is equal to 0 in decimal, which is not true, because when you subtract 1 from 2, the answer is going to be 1. But here we are getting 0. So we have to add this 1 back to the result and this will give us 0, 0, 0, 1. And decimal equivalent of 0, 0, 0, 1 is 1. So this is the correct answer, not 0. So this is all for this presentation. Now we will move to homework problem. I have 4 homework problems for you. In first homework problem, you have to perform the subtraction 1011 minus 0100. In second homework problem, you have to perform the subtraction 0110 1011. In third homework problem, you have to perform the subtraction 11001. This is 5-bit number. 1111. This is 4-bit number. And in last homework problem, 10000. Again, 5-bit number. 11101. So these are the 4 homework problems. This is all for this presentation. See you in the next one.